This is my small office here at the University for International Business and Economics in Beijing. You'll notice that I have a roll of toilet paper because the bathrooms here don't have any. You also have to bring your own hand soap. If you don't bring toilet paper to the bathroom, then that's bad for you. If you don't bring hand soap to the bathroom, that's not only bad for you, but it's bad for everybody that you interact with for the rest of the day. In other words, it's what economists call an externality. I work on another type of externality related to carbon emissions and pollution relating to climate change. So today what I want to do is give you a very brief introduction to kind of a climate perspective of an American here in China.
The world population can be divided into five China-sized chunks. The first three chunks are China, India, and the other developing countries in Asia. As I'm reminded every time I take the subway, there are a lot of people in Asia. The fourth China-sized chunk, known to economists as the OECD, includes the rich world countries of North America, Europe, and Japan. China number five is dominated by Africa and South America. Each of these five Chinas has about 1.4 billion people. What I'm seeing firsthand here in Beijing is what economists call catch-up. The Chinese want to have weddings like ours, they want to consume like we do, they want nice cars, they want to leave Inner Mongolia and vacation in the big city, they even want to sing like us. The climate challenge, of course, is that the atmosphere is already crowded with carbon dioxide. Stuffing in even more CO2 emissions could make for a rough ride. Population growth in Asia and Africa will add another China's worth of people to the planet by 2030. But the most important factor will be developing economies catching fire and increasing CO2 emissions per person. Here's the latest data for the five Chinas. China's emissions, which are still less than half the rich world average, have doubled in only 10 years, and they may double again by 2030. Per capita emissions in India and other developing countries are also likely to grow quickly. There's a lot to celebrate as the other four Chinas catch up with the rich world over the coming decades. But climate change is likely to be a major negative. My job as an environmental economist is figuring out how to limit that potential downside.